Good morning. Okay, lesson number 4. Let's see what's hidden on that canvas. First thing I do is I'm going to get out a little paint. I have an idea today that I'm going to do a cityscape. Kind of rare for me. So I'm going to start out with a little bit of my titanium white. There we go. Got some actually open right here. Always look at what you have open. Very important. And I'm basically going to work with a palette knife and see what happens. I'm going to give just a little bit of painting medium in the form of a Galkid gel and palette knife. Oh heck, let's start with the big one. I got my music going. I don't have to think about the outside world for just a few minutes. So I love this shape. I love the shape that's made by buildings. Especially in Manhattan, where the buildings are a little taller in scale than they are here in Brooklyn. And these paintings, which I started doing in about 1997, although that's not true. The very first one I did was in 1975 or so. And then I returned to it again and again. I call them canyons, and they're really very much, there's no question, I don't mind saying it, they're inspired by those early cityscapes that George O'Keefe did. You know, the ones where you have the canyon of the city going down. I'm never ashamed of being influenced. I think all art is influenced. People wonder what originality is, and people say, oh, that's not original. Well, originality is in fact a recycling of everything that's happened before with just a little teeny tiny eensy weensy, about that big, bit of difference. It's kind of like in music. Are there new notes, or is it that configuration of notes which somehow makes a very slight difference, and then that very slight difference becomes everything? Actually, within that slight difference, you could say, is where art resides. I love in this the scrape of the knife across the relative roughness of the surface. Now I'm using canvas instead of linen in these news paintings. I in many ways prefer linen. Oh, actually I'm wrong. This is linen. How about that? It's not cotton duct, it's linen. And even as I said that, I realized, wait a minute, that's a pretty fine weave to be cotton. But I love linen because I feel like it's a little bit tighter. Has a tighter weave and it's also heavier. stronger. Doesn't stretch out as easily. There it is, the water tower. The water tower is really to New York what the cathedral tower, or the church tower is to Europe. I didn't make that up. Somebody came up with that. But I'd like to think it was mine. Just like these forms. I didn't make these up. These forms have existed in art since the beginning of time. I think what I like about doing these canyon paintings is I'm making basically a gigantic negative shape. And from that negative shape, I will build out the illusion of depth. Oh, yeah. Now, oh, yes, let's come over here. Whee! And let's take a little bit of a look here. A little bit of a look-see. Let me see if I can turn this thing around. How do I do that? Oh, no, I can't. So I guess I have to look like this. Yeah. So you see, this is the shape of my sky. These are my buildings. Buildings on the left, buildings on the right. This is the shape of the canyon as it goes down. Okay, I think we got that. Now let's get a little bit of a roadway in here. That's what happens when you get paint all over your palette knife and you don't know it. Then the best thing to do is wipe it off. Yeah. Now maybe, just maybe, I'm gonna go in with my brush. And I'm gonna give this a little bit of color, a little warm for the horizon. A little yellow. Ah. Whoops. There you go. There you go. You see that? Yes. Yeah. And now a little of my painting medium. Basically, although this has a Galkit oil, it's the equivalent of a linseed oil, a Damar varnish, and odorless paint thinner, or turpentine, if you will. Now let's turn around so we can see our canvas. There we go. Okay. I'm just gonna work it right into the surface. I like to put in those cornices on the buildings. What I love about painting is that it changes. You know, broaden this out a little bit. I can change it. I can push it, I can pull it. I can adjust it. You know, there are some materials where I think for example, watercolor, which is an extraordinary medium. But sometimes with watercolor, not always, sometimes you are absolutely needing to stay with what you've put there. I mean, it's hard to paint over a watercolor. Oil paint, acrylic paint, other paints which have opacity, you can push and pull them, you can change them, you can wipe them out, you can do anything you want. And you're working on a good solid surface. I mean, you know, in a watercolor, you're working usually on paper as a ground. So if you rub that too much, it's going to disintegrate on you, especially because the paper is moist. Now we're getting somewhere. Now, remember in my previous lesson, I talked about each stroke making a difference. I think that's true. I think that's true. It's something that an idea that I refuted, that I worked against for decades. I thought, that makes the art too precious. But now I'm at a point where I realize the wisdom of that. Every time you lay your brush on the canvas, it counts. You know, I like dragging on the linen because it reminds me of the great British painter. Francis Bacon. And if you look how he works, we call this, by the way, a scum bowl. A scum bowl, that's it. Scum bowl, scum bowl, scum bowl, scum bowl, scum bowl. You drag wet paint over a dry surface, and the scumble is caused by the actual texture of the surface picking up the paint. Now, this is quite a smooth linen, not a portrait linen, but a good landscape linen. And if I were to use a really rough linen, something even as rough or canvas as, let's say, a burlap, my scumbles would be big and meaty. These are more refined. Yeah, getting some. Uh-huh. And what the heck? Let's go ahead and play around with that sky a little bit. A little bit of a cerulean blue. Wonderful blue. It's got a touch of a warm shade in it. Let's see if we can get this down here. Yeah. Okay. Okay, so now, there you go. Oop. Wet on wet. Mix it in. Kind of low contrast at this point. That's fine. Lost my water tower. Now I'm beginning to get it pretty well blocked in. Uh-huh. So that's going to be it for today. I'm going to let that dry up a little bit, and I'll see you tomorrow.